Google has changed everything that we know about AI coding with this new Google Antigravity IDE, an agentic coding editor that's taking cursor heads on, and from my initial testing, it's absolutely insane. It comes packed with features and a layout we've not seen before in other AI coding editors, and of course, the familiar VS Code styled interface that we all know and love. It was released along Gemini 3.0, and it caught everyone off guard. And it's been trending since then. So in this video, I'll give you a complete beginner tutorial to show you how each of the features work. And we'll be building a complete app together to help you understand how it works and how you can start using it in your workflow. If you're new here, my name is Joe. I test and review AI models and AI coding tools daily and publish my findings. Hit that subscribe button to help us keep going. Thank you. First, when I tested it, it was like I was dreaming. I just come from reviewing the new Cursor 2.0, which introduced multiple agents working on the same project concurrently. But now, Antigravity is blowing up everything that we know about AI coding editors. Let me break down what makes this Antigravity IDE so special. First, it's powered by Google's Vertex model, and it gives you access to multiple frontier models that include Gemini 3 Pro, Claude Sonnet 4.5, and even GPT models, all in one editor. And you can switch between them depending on the task you're working on. But here is where it gets wild. Antigravity comes in two modes, or it works in two distinct modes. The planning mode for complex tasks where the agent actually plans before executing, organizing your work into task groups and producing artifacts for optimal quality. Then there's the fast mode, which is simple for tasks that are easy, like renaming variables or running quick bash commands when speed matters. The agent system is unlike anything we've seen. It's a multi-step reasoning system that can reason over your existing code base using a wide range of tools, including browser built-in subagent, and it can spin multiple agents in the conversation and in parallel. You heard that right. Yes, multiple agents working simultaneously on different parts of the project, like we saw on Cursor if you checked out the other videos on Cursor. And speaking of browser subagents, Antigravity can literally open and read and control your Chrome browser. It can test the development website like you usually test. It can read internet data sources, automate browser tasks, and even record actions as artifacts. It runs in separate Chrome profile to keep everything organized or isolated from your personal browsing. The interface now is divided into two parts like we saw in Cursor. We have the editor part, which is the traditional code editing, and the agent manager, where you can orchestrate all your agents and toggle between the two using simple keyboard shortcuts. Antigravity also introduces task groups, which break down complex problems into units of work. You can see what each agent is doing, review pending action, and the agent can even ask you to review before making major changes, depending on your settings. Now, let's look at how to actually get started with Google Antigravity IDE. Let's get Antigravity installed and configure it so that you can start using it right away. Head over to antigravity.google/download. Antigravity is available for macOS, Windows, and Linux. Check out the details for each version that is supported. The download is straightforward. You just select the operating system, download the installer, and run it. The application will automatically prompt you when updates are available, so you can always stay current. When you first launch Antigravity, you'll need to authenticate with a Google account. Here is something important. Antigravity currently works with non-workspace personal Google accounts in approved geographies. So if you're having trouble trying to get your personal gmail.com address working, use workspace account instead. Once you are in, you'll see two main areas. The editor, which looks and feels like VS Code because it's built on similar foundation, and the agent manager, which is your command center for all AI interactions. You can open the agent manager from the editor by clicking the button at the top bar or using command plus E on Mac and control plus E on Windows. From the agent manager, you can jump back to the editor the same way. This seamless switching is key to the Antigravity workflow. One of Antigravity's killer features is the browser subagent, but it requires a bit of setup. First, ensure you have Google Chrome installed. If you don't, download it from google.com/chrome. The first time you use the browser agent, Antigravity will direct you to Chrome Web Store to install Antigravity browser extension. This extension is required for the agent to see and interact with your websites. Here is what makes it smart. Antigravity runs in a separate Chrome profile completely isolated from your normal browsing. This means none of your personal cookies, sign-in, or browser history will be accessed by the agent. However, any accounts you sign in to while using Antigravity will persist in this separate profile for future use. If Chrome was already open, when you launch the Antigravity browser, you'll see it as a separate application in your dock. To return to your normal Chrome profile, just quit the application and relaunch Chrome normally. Before we start coding, let's configure some key settings. Hit Command plus comma or Control plus comma to open the settings, or click the gear icon in the Agent Manager. Navigate to the Agent section. Here you can set your default reasoning model. You have access to Gemini 3 Pro in high and low variants, Claude Sonnet 4.5 with and without extended thinking, and GPT models. For most tasks, I recommend starting with Gemini 3 Pro high, but you can switch the model mid-conversation depending on what you're working on. This is crucial. You have three options. Always proceed means the agent never asks for review and just executes. Request review means the agent always stops and waits for your approval. Agent decides is the hybrid approach where AI determines when it needs your input. I personally like to use agent decides for best balance of speed and control. This controls how the agent handles terminal commands. Off means it never auto-executes except for commands in your allow list. Auto lets the agent decide when to auto-execute, while turbo always auto-executes except for commands in your deny list. For security, you can configure allow and deny list in the settings. I recommend starting with auto mode and adding specific commands to your deny list as needed. By default, Antigravity only accesses files in your current workspace and the Antigravity root folder. There's a setting to allow access to files outside the workspace, but use this with extreme caution as it exposes sensitive data or secrets to the agent. For the browser, there's a two-layer security system. First, there's a deny list maintained by Google that blocks dangerous URLs. If the server is available, access is denied by default for safety. Second, there's a local allow list you can control. During onboarding, you can pre-populate it with common trusted URLs. When the agent tries to access the site not allowed on your allow list, you'll get a prompt with an always allow button. Click on it to add the URL to your allow list for the future access. You can manually edit your allow list anytime in the browser settings, but remember the deny list always takes precedence. You cannot allow list a URL that appears in the Google deny list. Currently, Antigravity is in a no-cost public preview. You get a generous rate limit of Gemini 3 Pro and a more conservative limit for other Vortex model garden models. These limits reset every 5 hours. The rate limits are based on the amount of work the agent does, not just the number of prompts. Simple tasks consume less quota, complex tasks consume more. According to Google, a very few power users ever hit the 5-hour limit, so you should feel unrestrained in your usage. There's currently no paid tier, no bring your own key option, and no organization accounts, but this may come, of course, in the future. Now that everything is configured, let's create a workspace. In the Agent Manager, you can create a workspace by clicking on the plus icon or using the appropriate keyboard shortcut. Choose a folder in your system where the project will live. You can create multiple workspaces for different projects, and the agent can work across all of them simultaneously if needed. Each workspace maintains its own context, terminal session, and files changes. Now we are ready to start building. Let's see what Antigravity can do. Let's build our first complete application from scratch using Antigravity and see how it handles real-world scenario of coding. We'll create a task management app with a backend API and a front-end interface. Open the Agent Manager and start a new conversation. You will immediately see the choice between planning and fast mode. For building a complete app, we definitely want planning mode. This is where Antigravity is going to help us understand its capability for planning apps. In the prompt box, let's give the agent a clear task. Let's type something like create a full stack task management application using Node.js, Express backend, and a React frontend. Include authentication, task, CRUD, operations, and maybe use a clean modern UI. Now let's see how the magic happens. In the planning mode, the agent doesn't jump in and start coding. It thinks through the entire architecture first, and you see it break down the project into task groups. The agent creates high-level plan showing the database schema, API endpoints, front-end components, and everything that we need to connect together to build this app successfully. This is presented as an artifact that you can review and comment on. Notice how it organizes the work into logical sections, setting up the project, building backend, creating database models, developing API routes, building front-end components, implementing authentication, each task as a task group, and the agent will work through each of them systematically. Now let's dive into our first task group. You'll see the goal at the top, summarizing what the unit of work accomplishes. Below that are the edited files shown as peers. Click on any file and you can see the current state of that file and what changes have been made. With each task group, the agent identifies the subtask. By default, the detailed steps are collapsed to keep things clean, but you can expand them to see exactly what the agent did on each step. This is incredibly useful for learning and debugging. Sometimes the agent creates pending steps that need your approval, like running npm install commands or starting development servers. This appears in a special section at the end of the task group where you can review and approve them. As an agent works, you can switch models based on the task at hand. For architectural decisions or complex logic, Gemini 3 Pro Higher or Claude 4.5 Sonnet with thinking are excellent choices. For simple tasks like writing boilerplate code or CSS styling, you might want to switch to Gemini Pro Low version to save on your rate limit. The model selection is sticky within a conversation turn, so if you change, it will get the agent working. It will finish the current task with the previous model and switch for the next one. Once the agent has built the initial app, let's ask it to test the frontend in the browser. Let me type something like open the app in Chrome and test user registration flow. Maybe that is a good one. The browser agent springs into action and launches Chrome in the separate Antigravity profile. It navigates to the localhost and starts interacting with the app. You can see it clicking forms, filling buttons, validating user experience, and so on. The agent captures screenshots or even video recordings as artifacts, showing you exactly what it's doing. If it encounters a bug or maybe UI issues, identifies them and you can immediately jump back to the code and fix them. You can have an AI that can write code, test in real browser, identify issues and fix them autonomously. That's a new one. Here, it's where Antigravity gets even more powerful. You can spin up multiple agents' conversation, have them work in parallel, something that we also saw in Cursor 2.0. Let's say we have the main agent building the frontend for you, and you want another agent to set up your CI/CD pipelines. You start a second agent, and in the same workspace, this agent can work on deployment configuration, maybe Docker setup, GitHub action workflows, where the first agent continues building the features. Both agents have access to the same codebase and can coordinate their changes. This parallel execution dramatically speeds up development on complex projects. At any point, you can click on Review Changes button on the top right. It opens a pane where you can scroll through all the diffs made during the conversation. You can leave comments on specific lines, ask the agent to modify certain changes, or accept everything. Switch to the Source Control tab within the Review Changes pane, and here you can see all change files, stage or unstaged them individually, and commit them with a message. It's full Git integration right within Antigravity. You can press Command plus J or Control J to open the terminal at the bottom of the window. This terminal is attached to your workspace and you can run commands that you need. The agent can also generate and execute terminal commands based on your request. For example, you can say install dependencies that start the development server. The agent generates the appropriate NPM commands. Depending on a terminal auto-execution settings, it either runs them automatically or asks for your approval. You can have multiple terminal sessions, switch between them, and the agent maintains context of what it's running and where it's running. Antigravity has knowledge system where you can add documentation, API references, coding standards, or context that you want the agent to always have access to. Click on the knowledge in the agent manager to add the items. For a task management app, you might add maybe the company API design guidelines, preferred React patterns, or security requirements. The agent will reference this knowledge when making decisions. You can also set up custom rules and workflows. These are like persistent instructions for how the agent should work. Example, always write tests for new API endpoints, or use TypeScript strict modes for all of the files. As the agent builds the app, you can jump in at any point with refinements, say like add dark mode support to the UI, or maybe implement a rate limit for the API endpoints. Finally, we can deploy this app. We can tell the agent, set up the deployment to Vercel for the frontend and Railway for the backend. Configure environmental variables and ensure everything is production ready. The agent will handle all the deployment configuration, sets up all the necessary accounts if you've provided the credential, and walks you through the deployment process. It can even commit the deployment configs to a repository for future use. Antigravity also supports advanced features such as model context protocol, which allow you to add or connect to external sources and tools. In this case, data sources. You can integrate your company, internal APIs, databases, design system, or any other resources the agent might need. This extensibility makes Antigravity suitable for enterprise use, where the agent needs access to your internal systems and workflows. Wrapping up, we've gone from zero to fully deployed task management application using Google Antigravity IDE. We've seen the planning mode in action, we've worked with the task groups, we've leveraged the browser subagent, run multiple agents in parallel, and deployed to production. The key takeaways from this video is Antigravity's planning mode makes it think before it acts, resulting in high quality code. The multi-agent parallel execution speeds up complex projects dramatically. The browser subagent eliminates the testing bottleneck, and the familiar VS Code interface means zero learning curve for the editor itself. Currently, Antigravity is at no cost in public preview with generous remits. There's no paid tier, but this is an incredible opportunity to get hands-on with this tool, which might be one of the best AI coding or AI code editors of the future. If you found this tutorial useful, kindly hit that subscribe button and leave a comment below on what you'd like us to build with Antigravity. I'm always testing these AI coding tools daily and publishing my findings, so you'll want to stay tuned for more comparison. And finally, do not forget to subscribe and like this video. One like, one subscribe gives me one more step forward to bringing great content. Thank you, and I appreciate it.